What a difference in your day. Seems as though your troubles disappear like a feather in your way.
Verrucas and warts are easily spread, but Bazooka Gel offers a clinically proven treatment with no need for plasters. So bazooka that verruca.
Tina?
Claire? I thought you'd be back tomorrow.
Have you been wearing my perfume?
Have I?
Is that the wine I was saving?
Was it?
Have you opened my gold blend?
No.
I can smell it.
He's an aromatherapist.
Who is?
Hi.
Gold blend from Nescafe with the golden aroma.
Did he enjoy my aroma?
Nescafe.
Don't be late for the Dolland and Aitchison half-price sale.
Marvellous.
Lurpak Spreadable. Smoother by half.
Where are you going for your summer holiday, then?
Hey, not decided yet.
Portugal's really nice this time of year.
You're not a golfer, are you?
Ibiza! You'd love Ibiza.
For Great Lake deals, we're the biggest in the UK, so we'll find the perfect holiday for you. Don't just book it. Thomas Cook it.
New from Brita. The only water filter jugs that tell you when it's time to change your Brita cartridge. Electronically. Brita does wonders for water.
If you're not too sure about the Euro question...
There's all sorts of other questions that's introduced.
Let's talk about the class struggle. The class struggle.
It's absolute nonsense. I mean, what does that teach anybody?
The answer isn't all this right-wing nonsense that you're coming out with.
You might say that, but...
I just did.
Late Night Live, 10:30 Tuesday on ITV.
Hello, good evening. I'm Anna Maria Ash. This is London Tonight. The owners of a cut-price travel agency in North London have disappeared with £50,000 of customers' money. Trading Standards officers raided Ozone Travel in Enfield and found it deserted. Hundreds of holidaymakers have been left holding worthless tickets for flights to the Caribbean and America. Christopher Peacock reports.
Unanswered letters from angry holidaymakers left lying on the mat as hundreds face ruined holidays after the owners of a North London travel agency disappeared with £50,000 worth of payments. They all booked flights with an unlicensed company known as Ozone Travel, which suddenly stopped trading. Trading Standards officers raided the office in New Southgate on Monday, only to discover it had been abandoned. They'd been deluged with complaints from travellers after flight tickets didn't turn up. Despite not being registered with APTA, the travel industry's regulator, hundreds of people parted with their money in exchange for cheap holiday flights.
Unfortunately, most people who paid by cheque or cash, there's very little they can do now unless we're able to establish some links with the ATOL number that was quoted in the advertisements. Those that booked by credit card, and people had booked by credit card as early as April, will be able to claim their money back through the credit card companies.
85% of UK travel agents are registered APTA members. 27 of them went bust last year. Police are now helping Trading Standards officers to trace the owners of Ozone Travel. In North London, this is Christopher Peacock for London Tonight.
The parents of a six-week-old baby boy are being questioned by detectives after he was admitted to Basildon Hospital in Essex with severe head injuries. The couple, who are aged in their 20s, were arrested after ambulance staff were called to the family home in Leyndon. The child's condition is described as serious but stable. Commuters in East London faced delays this evening after an unexploded World War II bomb closed part of the Docklands Light Railway. It was discovered by workmen at the Royal Victoria Docks. Army bomb disposal experts were called in to examine the device. It's expected to be detonated tomorrow. A driver has had an amazing escape after his lorry crashed on the M1. His truck hit the central reservation near Junction 15 on the northbound carriage of the motorway and burst into flames. The accident caused severe delays. The Post Office has been granted new powers to help deal with the passport crisis. From next week, main branches will be able to extend passports that have recently expired. The move comes after hundreds continued to queue at Petit France. Harrods boss, Mohamed Al-Fayed, provided refreshments for those waiting in line. Ronke Phillips has this report.
As the misery continued for the hundreds of people queuing up outside the passport office, their plight drew sympathy from the man who's waited 5 years and still hasn't managed to get a British passport. Harrods owner Mohamed Al-Fayed arranged for his staff to serve tea and coffee to the people who've been waiting in the rain, and his generous gesture was appreciated.
Well, we know how he feels now, don't we? Trying to get a passport, it's absolutely impossible, isn't it? Cheers, Al-Fayed.
Well, he's been waiting for a number of years for his passport, and obviously these people are having difficulty obtaining their passport too. So anything he can do to ease their burden, you know, he's glad to.
The delays have been caused by a combination of new computer technology and rules requiring newborn babies to have their own passports. The backlog means many people still don't have their official travelling document days before they're due to leave.
They're guaranteed that the passports would arrive on Wednesday, which they haven't. So it's my kid's passport, so we're travelling on Sunday, so it's the last chance.
I'm not leaving until I get it. I've got to go tomorrow morning.
The backlog is not expected to be fully cleared before August. Mr. Fayed may have a slightly longer wait for his passport. In Petit France, this is Ronke Phillips for London Tonight.
A London doctor has been struck off after becoming the first GP to be convicted of helping to flood the black market with the date rape drug Rohypnol. The General Medical Council was told 63-year-old Helen Sweeney, who's from Pimlico, prescribed nearly 10,000 of the pills. Three officers have been suspended at Brixton Prison for alleged misconduct. The prison service says the offences are not linked to violence or drugs. It follows an investigation into complaints made by an inmate. As yet, no one has been charged with any criminal offence. A play based on the Stephen Lawrence inquiry is to be performed at the National Theatre. The Colour of Justice received critical acclaim when it premiered at Kilburn's Tricycle Theatre in January. The play will open at the National in September as part of a tour. Meanwhile, Miss Saigon, one of the West End's most popular musicals, is to close. Its final performance will take place on October the 30th. Impresario Sir Cameron McIntosh will be replacing the show with a musical version of The Witches of Eastwick. And that's our late news. A very good night to you. Bye-bye.
Carlton Weather is sponsored by Amarada, the energy company.
Hello there once again. The cloud continues to break up. There's some mist around and a fairly murky feel to things all in all. So we go into tomorrow morning on a misty, murky old note. Thankfully it doesn't last. During the course of the day, the cloud breaks up. We've some sunshine coming through and a high of 25, 77 in Fahrenheit, and that's a couple of degrees up on today's values. So now a quick look ahead to the weekend. And on Saturday there will be some rain around to begin the day, and then the sky's clear. We see the cloud breaking up and some sunshine coming through. A fresher feel to things on Saturday. In fact, 22 is 72 in Fahrenheit. Come Sunday is almost the reverse. Brightness to begin with, some rain later on in the day, and these temperatures are more or less a few degrees above average. So unsettled weekend, but fairly warm. That's all from me.
For a more detailed 5-day outlook, call Weather Update, sponsored by Amarada.